Hello students, welcome back. Today I'll be explaining you part 2 of geography of chapter 1. Today we will be learning about the classification of rocks, and the rocks can be classified into 3 parts: igneous, metamorphic, sedimentary. If I'll be talking about the igneous rock, it is derived from the Latin word ignis, meaning fire. It is formed when the molten magma solidifies. They are called primary rocks, also known as parent rock, from which all other rocks are formed. As you have seen many types of rocks, so these rocks are being formed by the igneous rocks, or I can say that igneous rock are the parent rock from which all other rocks are formed, and these comprise 85% of the lithosphere. Moving ahead, now igneous rock, it can be classified into 2 types. One is intrusive rock and another one is extrusive rock. These rocks are formed when the molten magma fails to break through the crust, slowly solidifies under earth's surface. That means when the molten magma, it is unable to take a form, then intrusive rocks are being formed. Now I'll be talking about the extrusive rocks. These rocks are formed when the molten magma comes out on the earth's surface as lava and cools quickly. As soon as we will see that lava is coming out and it has been there and cooling on the surface, then the rock whichever is going to be formed, that will be named as the extrusive rock. Moving ahead with sedimentary rocks. The sedimentary rocks are formed from the sediments or eroded fragments of existing rocks. Now, how these rocks can be eroded? There are some of the natural forces like rivers, glaciers, wind, plants and animals break rocks into fragments. These are the factors which are responsible that breaks the rocks into the fragments. Once again, I would like to show you: rivers, glaciers, wind, plants and animals break rocks into fragments. Moving ahead, sedimentary rocks can be classified into 3 types. Now I'll be explaining you about the sedimentary rocks, and these rocks can be classified into 3 types. First one is mechanically formed, second one is chemically, and the third one is organically. If I'm talking about mechanically, these are formed by physical accumulation of material. Now, the physical forms are being accumulated at one place, and these kind of rocks are being formed. Chemically formed, these are formed by chemical processes. Chemical processes, you can see that whether it is the climatical changes or any kind of such circumstances take place, whether the one or more than one chemical reactions takes place, so these kind of rocks are being formed. The third one is organically formed sedimentary rocks. These are formed from the remains of sea organism and decayed plants. Now, whatever is been remaining, those characters or those things make the sedimentary rocks, and these can be the decayed plants or the sea organism. So they are giving us the information that how organically sedimentary rocks are formed. Now, main features of sedimentary rocks are: these rocks are non-crystalline structure. These rocks present in layered or stratified structure. That means these rocks you will always find in layers. There is no flat surface, nothing like that. You will always see these rocks into the form of layers, which is dividing one another from each other. They are softer than igneous rock. The rocks sometimes contain remains of dead plants and animals, also called fossils, in between the layers of the sediments. Sedimentary rocks are good source of fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, natural gas, which are formed from these fossil fuels. This was all about this video, and soon I'll be telling you about the further details of this chapter.